Vicky, we're on the eve of the holiday season. As a matter of fact, I think when this will be broadcast, we will be into the holiday season. Mm. Now, you've been involved in organizing entertainment for 24 years down here on the coast. This season, somebody who visits Ehouset, local or a visitor, what would you suggest? What should they do?
Thank you. And first, I'd like to congratulate you on the concept, because what I love about it is, as we've just discussed, as you know, with these events that we put onto the beach, every day when the weather changes, the event changes. So it would be great to be able to keep the site updated so that people can refer to the site to see if things have been cancelled or moved forward. So that's a great mechanism. So congratulations. It's a really, really good initiative.
Thank you.
It's a very busy season for us. Occupancy figures are sitting at about 80% this season, which is very, very good for the coast. We normally run between 60 and 80 for a winter season. I think that with the petrol increases, people tend to look towards KZN because it's a more affordable destination. So we always find, the trends have always been, that when petrol prices go up, we are busier. Funnily enough, one would have expected it to work in the other way, but it doesn't. So we're looking at good occupancy levels. There's over 50 days worth of entertainment planned for the visitors. It's all for free, and I think that makes it important as well, because obviously we are in a recession. And it's just fun and games for the family, lots of entertainment. The mom and dad can relax in the sun and the kiddies are entertained. So that's the Sardine Festival, which will be hosted on Margate Beachfront. Jazz bands, obviously this weekend is the Uga Jazz Festival, so we have a lot of media in the area that will be attending this. So it's a busy weekend for the coast. With the media, it's a good opportunity for us to let everybody know what's happening on the beaches. We focus our activities on Margate Beach, Aberdeen, Port Edward, Scottsborough, and St. Michael's. So lots of fun and entertainment for all family members. During that same time period, towards the tail end of the season, we have the Portuguese Festival, which I'm very excited about, because this year it's a proper Portuguese food and wine festival. We've managed to attract Portuguese communities from all over South Africa, and the focus is on the food. So the program will go out as a menu, so when you get to the Port Edward Holiday Resort, the hall will be transformed into a massive Portuguese dining area. And we have got non-stop Portuguese dancers, singers, entertainers coming from all over South Africa to really create a wonderful atmosphere for the visitor. So those that's one of our main events. And then moving on to that, we have the Africa Marine Expo, mm-hmm. which is hosted in Scottsborough. It's in the second year of this event. We're starting our own Mr. Price Pro, because we asked Mr. Price to come to us quite a few times and they weren't able to. So we're doing our own professional surf challenge on Scottsborough Beachfront. And that's going to be surrounded by incredible environmental talks, environmental expo areas, leisure expo areas, a very, very big children's festival, and lots of entertainment for the whole family, including tag and release, and lots of education around what happens out in our oceans.
Before we go on to something else, though, you mentioned the occupancy rate of 80%. Mm. Now, it's happened before that there were high occupancy rates during the holidays and the high seasons. But then the businessmen say, okay, high occupancy rate, but people don't spend.
Mm. Mm.
They come down here, you mentioned the petrol price, mm. but then they don't spend. Mm. Do you find the same, mm. tendency?
And after every season, I phone the top five businesses in the area to check to see how we're doing in terms of what the spend was like. And the people that I phone are people who keep products that the consumer wants to purchase. It's all well and good complaining about people not purchasing, but if you're not holding the correct product, it has to be something different. When these people come down, they are surrounded by magnificent shopping centres. Our shopping is not necessarily as competitive as these.
Yeah.
So it has to be a unique product. And that's why it's important that we look at creating local artifact, local items that have been produced, so that it's different and unique. And I feel that I think that there's a lot to be said about that. So yes.
And also the service that they receive. If the service is not good, they're not going to go back to the restaurant or wherever.
Absolutely, yes.
Okay, then somewhat negative. The statements from various quarters over the past few years that because of the neglect of the infrastructure down here, that this part of the coast, and especially Margate, is mm. dying,
mm.
and that Margate will never be the same as it used to be.
Mm.
What do you say about that, sort of drawing from your experience mm. over the past 24 years?
Well, from an events perspective, because I can really only comment from a sponsorship attraction point of view, as we sit here now, which is in June, December is fully booked for Margate Beach. every single top corporate festival that can happen in the country is booked for Margate, and we're now looking to position other festivals on other beaches because Margate is fully booked. Mm. So I think that the sponsor certainly sees it as a desirable destination. We have to look and focus on our assets. The asset is that mile-long stretch of sand that links Margate and Lucien Beach. It's a big beach. You can do a lot. You can set up a lot. So from a sponsor's point of view, Margate is still king. If we look at Africa Bike Week, for instance, Harley Davidson could have chosen any town in the whole of South Africa to set up their event, which, as you know, is the biggest biking festival in the Southern Hemisphere. They chose Margate. Admittedly, once we finish dressing up the town, the old lady turns into a glamorous queen, and then when they leave again, it's always a little bit of a, you know, because it goes back to being what it is, a small coastal village. But I think it has the potential. We're looking at another major event, which we can't discuss because it's still in the process of being of sponsors being sought and of getting the necessary permissions. But it's a massive racing car event that they haven't gone to Camps Bay, and they haven't gone to other areas. They've come to Margate. So
that's the street race.
Yes, that's correct. Yes.
Okay. Any news on that yet?
Well, we're in the process. It's going to be costly because we need to find a lot of sponsorship to pay for the road repair.
Yeah.
Yes, and there's widening and that type of thing, and also having we need to build Armco, and we need to do. In fact, there's a lot of opportunities with this event because if we manage to secure it, and we manage to build our own Armco and store it, we could turn Margate into a racing town. Every 3 months, we could host a different race, which would be incredible. But obviously, it's still in it's very much in its beginning. This is the beginning stages. But the point is that the organisers, which is the same company that hosted Top Gear this weekend, are looking at Margate. So that's good news for our area.
Mm. Okay, but having said that, you and I know that there is a serious problem: roads, potholes, etc., etc. Now, how would you suggest if you were in the shoes of the Hibiscus Coast Municipality, how would you solve that problem?
I've always said that you get further with honey than you do with vinegar. And I think that working together with the municipality, as opposed to going and sensationalising it through the media or bringing in television expose groups that come in and do sensationalised stories that are often one-sided, I believe working with council would get the local people further. We had a pothole outside our restaurant, and it took a few letters and a few phone calls, and they came and they fixed it. I think that it's just a case of keeping up with the communication and being positive about it still, not drawing on the negatives. We have to remain positive.
Okay, I hear what you say, but from certain ratepayers' organisations, we get the message that they have done what you suggest, they have spoken to the municipality, and then they get promises, but then nothing happens. It's words. They say it only remains words. I mean, have you had...
Yes.
No. You know what I mean?
For my experiences with Africa Bike Week, which now happened in the past month, every item that we highlighted that needed attending to was attended to. So I maybe just have a different type of relationship. So we were able to send an email and list items of concern, and the next day these items would be fixed. And in fact, the municipal manager would phone me every week to check on progress. So I think it's
maybe maybe you proved that honey does work.
Yes.
Vicky Wenzel, thank you very, very much. Thanks for your time.
Thank you.